So how was your Halloween and associated shit?
My Halloween was pretty excellent. Went to a burlesque show, dressed as Fancy Batgirl. Didn't win the costume contest, but you know. It was fun. How about you?
It wasn't canon accurate because Batgirl doesn't do a corset. That ain't...
You know, do you know my nephew actually said that to me today? I showed him a picture of my costume and he was like, I'm so proud of him. He's like, Batgirl doesn't wear that. I'm like, yeah, I know. I was like, Fancy Batgirl. There's no such thing as Fancy Batgirl. And I was a little bit proud of him. Because
worst costume ever.
But it was the best costume ever. Did you see how sparkly I was? And I had a boa instead of a cape. I thought that was really clever.
You want to show everybody? I can put a link up if you want to.
Sure.
All right. Well, send me the picture link so I can put it on the screen. Everybody can see. See, I didn't dress up.
Did you give out candy to children?
I intended to, but no kids knocked. It got to be like late in the evening, like about 7 o'clock, and I'm like, you know what? If any kid shows up, I'm just gonna be like, give him all the candy I have and be like, you fucking
just
win.
Dump the bowl in and be like, jackpot!
You win! Congrats, and be like, you know, but then 7 o'clock, yeah, is late. It's late, because taking the kids out, they don't come much later than that. But and then I get a text from Allison saying, hey, Brad's having a party tonight. You want to go? And I'm like, okay. So we drove an hour to have a party with Cinema Snob and his folks, and it was cool. It was fun.
Yeah, I'm trying to get the... move that window. And stuff. We're going to get the tweet. I don't know why I'm doing a strong bad voice.
And as we drove back, I subjected Allison to
You'll have link. I put it in the chat, not the...
That's okay.
Thing.
I subjected Allison to a hour and a half long Frank Turner concert.
Well, that's not bad. What's wrong with that?
I think she was less than plussed.
Oh.
Wouldn't say non-plussed, but less than. All right, let's put this over here so everybody can see it.
I saw a chick do burlesque as Lana from Archer, and she was amazing. She did a whole Archer-themed routine.
There we go. That's the...
Nella bedazzled that corset for me. I was supposed to wear a shorter skirt because I had these awesome stockings with bats all over them, but then a hole rotted through my leg.
Couldn't like tie like or put like a bat symbol over it or knee pads or something. Well, no, not.
So
knee pads.
I got a longer skirt.
Oh.
Which allowed me to wear flats, so wasn't all bad.
Yeah, but you could have like tied a scarf even though if you had a hole in your leg. Besides, you had a hole in your leg. It's very Halloween-y and also very Batman.
Well, yeah, Nella dressed as Poison Ivy and told me to try and make it look venomous and stuff. And I'm like, I'm not putting makeup on my leg hole. Nope. Had enough problems with it.
Leg hole has become almost a character on the show in and of itself.
It is getting better, although they gave me this new packing and I do not like it. My old packing was strips of antibiotic treated gauzy stuff, and you know, you cut off like a 6-inch strip, you stuffed it in there. This is little squares of like cottony stuff that's apparently treated with silver
colloid.
Yeah, but it has the texture of like insulation. So imagine all day insulation rubbing on your viscera. All day.
There's probably a website dedicated to just such a thing.
It feels so weird and gross. And then sometimes, if I'm really lucky, it just fuses itself to the wound and I can't get it out.
The word fuse and wound should not be... Those words don't belong in the same sentence.
No, they don't. And they're like, oh, just spray it with some water if it kind of sticks. And I'm like, no, that doesn't work.
They should be in separate zip codes.
It's part of my person now. Yeah. I'm going to gradually turn into this weird silver-treated insulation-like stuff.
Some Walking Dead shit there. It fused to the wound.
And I mean, I guess then I'll be antibiotic or antimicrobial.
Well, before we terrorize the entire audience with tales of your fused wound, shall we get to the pit?
Sorry. They ask for updates. They're like, hey, how's your leg hole? So that's the state of the leg hole. My weekly address.
All right, let's see here. Each week, Catherine and the Radio Dead Air audience go out in the worldwide interwebs, find all sorts of horrible stuff, bring it back here for a little segment we like to call What the Fuck is Wrong with You? And we got one to start with. It's going to be a little bit of a quick one, mainly because this falls into the why does this keep happening department. Do you remember the corn maze story? Real men fight the corn.
Oh, yes, the guy that beat up the corn maze.
Because they were stuck in the corn maze.
Yes.
And that happened, that was just after Halloween. Well, it is officially deja vu all over again. Visitors stuck inside world's largest corn maze, call 911 for help.
I guess at least it was the world's largest. I mean, that's kind of justified.
Dixon, California. What's supposed to be fall fun for some people is turning to law enforcement for help. Several visitors, the world's largest corn maze at Cool Patch Pumpkins in Dixon, are calling 911 when they find they can't get out.
Several.
The maze seems easy to maneuver through when you first get in, but once inside this massive 63-acre corn creation, it's pretty tough to get out. When it's dark, all you see is corn, said Matt Cooley, owner of the maze. That's a quote right there. When it's dark, all you see is corn.
I've never done a corn maze. I have to imagine, though, like, I saw the fourth Harry Potter movie, and I have to imagine if it's starting to get dark and you're fucking lost in a maze, like, it's got to be pretty scary. Like, you don't know if Victor Crumb is possessed and going to try and kill you.
Yeah, but I just, to get to the point where you're standing in the middle, it's 2014. You are standing in a field of corn.
You'd think these corn mazes would start giving out, like, walkie-talkies or something.
Or a helpline or something.
Right.
You get lost, give us a call.
Right. Like, you'd think they would have started to plan for this, that people are not smarter than rats and cannot solve a maze.
Just the first,
and may require assistance.
I can't even fault these people because when this happens, what the fuck else are you supposed to do?
Right, like what if they close down for the night and you're stuck in there? That's a horror movie waiting to happen.
Apparently the local police department is like, we got another one. It just keeps happening.
You think they have like a designated corn maze unit?
They say, Cooley, let's see. The guy who owns it says, everybody ends up getting out. Just don't call 911. Please, guys, you'll get out eventually.
But you'd really think they'd start to plan for this by now. Give people a walkie-talkie. Have a designated number. Have one employee with a burner phone whose job it is to field texts from lost people. Like,
corn maze tech support.
Yeah. How do people solve corn mazes before?
Well, you know, you have a GPS. You could probably figure this shit out.
I don't think those are on Google Maps. Well, it'll just tell you to walk in a straight line.
Yeah.
Like, all weekend, Google Maps kept telling me to drive through buildings. Like, just drive straight that way. And well, I'm like, that's great. There is a hotel there.
That's because it doesn't like New York, obviously.
I can't. Well, also, Queens hates me. Clearly, I wronged the borough of Queens in a past life, and it does not like me.
So, do you remember when you finally stopped trick-or-treating?
You stopped trick-or-treating?
Eventually get to an age where showing up at someone's a stranger's house dressed funny stops being cute.
Clearly you don't understand the nuclear option push-up bra I was wearing on Friday.
There is a point when you have to stop, but this guy, I don't.
Have you tried turning the maze off and on again?
this guy apparently does not understand there is a demarcation line for trick-or-treating, but he took matters into his own hands. Teletubby break-in suspect faces charges. Student accused of breaking into a friend's Pennsylvania home while wearing a yellow Teletubby costume and stealing leftover food is facing charges. They say the Lee University student was dressed as the La La character from the... I love how they have to point out exactly which Teletubby he was dressed as.
Lehigh University.
Lehigh.
Back in my baton twirling days, that's where we had our regional competition every year. University. I've been there.
He damaged a door early Sunday. Then they say he went into the friend's refrigerator and dumped Chinese food into a, quote, man purse before leaving. Okay, number one.
Called it a man purse?
I don't know. It's in quotes. So someone right. involved in this.
So AP style would suggest that that means somebody said it.
So this is not, last I checked, this is not how you trick or treat.
Look at the last line of the story, Nash.
Police Chief Mark DeLuzio says, not that many Teletubbies get arrested. You can't make it up.
Those Teletubbies survived child stardom for the most part. They were okay. I mean, the gay one turned out fine.
Which one was the gay one?
The purple one that had the purse and a triangle on its head.
Oh, so this guy's already canon inaccurate. Because he's the yellow one, but he's using a purse.
Right. Well, he's using a man purse. The purple one actually had a little red purse that hung over one arm, and it had a triangle on its head, and it was purple, so people surmised that it was gay. Although, they don't necessarily have a gender, those things. They're kind of horrifying alien babies, so I don't know how they could be gay.
You remember when we were kids, we came up with all sorts of ridiculous shit that signified someone was gay.
I know, but how can you be gay when you don't even have bits?
I'm actually kind of stumped here.
Okay. I mean, there's more to it than that, yes. Like, it's an emotional thing as well. So, but they were horrifying little alien babies. I don't think ascribing a sexuality to them is even really...
I love how this is his friend's house.
I want to know why he has a Lala costume.
Well, it was Halloween, obviously.
Grown people go as Teletubbies for Halloween still, because that show's not on the air anymore.
Yeah, they do. Because people are weird as shit. You know they do. They're weird as shit. Or it's that guy who bought the costume back when Teletubbies were still on the air. He's like, God damn it, I'm going to get my money's worth out of this fucking thing.
He just uses it as footy pajamas now. What symbol did the yellow one have on its head? Because that could be problematic for pajama use. Is that the one with just a stick? Because the joke's there.
Oh my God, where do I start?
Are those your pajamas, or are you just happy to see me?
Okay.
Who wears footy pajamas? People whose feet get cold.
So, do you remember the Jared diet?
Yes, because I used to live in Connecticut, and Subway is based in Connecticut, so you cannot fucking escape Subway in the state of Connecticut.
The whole idea that if you eat Subway and exercise regularly and have a sensible diet, you could lose a lot of weight. Remember that?
And if you're not eating the meatball marinara foot long, like I do when I go to Subway because I'm a fat ass, and chips and a big old soda.
It didn't work for some people. And, this guy took that a little personally. Alabama man allegedly robs 4 Subway stores in 4 days, blames Jared diet. Zachary Raphael Torrance arrested on first-degree robbery charges for holding up Subway sandwich stores. He was captured in a Walmart store Thursday night after a shopper recognized him from photos pasted on the local police's Facebook page. Quote, I don't know if he was kidding or not, but he said he tried the Jarrett diet and it hadn't worked for him, so he wanted his money back. All right, first off...
So he decided to steal it from several?
This guy's eyes are terrifying. I don't know what...
Oh.
I don't know what's going on there. But it's like gazing into the endless abyss.
He's eaten a lot of Subway.
He has seen some shit, man. That is a thousand-yard stare if ever there was one.
When you stare into the Subway... The Subway stares into you.
Good God Almighty. He just, Jesus. Let me see what else is going on here in the story. When Torrance was arrested, he was wearing the same outfit, orange shoes, and a black jacket that he wore during Wednesday's robbery. Really? You robbed the store and then you just keep wearing the same shit?
I mean, if you're robbing Subway, you're probably not extremely wealthy.
Yeah, but I have...
Maybe he did laundry in between and he just happened to put the same clothes back on. I'm not going to lie to you, I worry about this because I wear all black for work, so I have a big old closet of just black clothes. But I'm in different places every day, so I'm like, am I wearing the exact same outfit as I was last time I was here? Will they notice? Are they going to think I just wear this outfit every day? Maybe he's like Smurfette, and he just has 16 of the same outfit.
My poor bastard.
He's got the crazy eyes real bad.
He does! Can you just imagine him telling police, I tried the Subway diet, it didn't work.
And he's like clenching his teeth, too, like,
I wanted my money back.
Eat fresh.
And the fucked up thing here is, most corporations don't like bad publicity. So all you had to do was raise enough of a fuss, and I promise you, you would have either got your money back or gotten a fuck bunch of store credit. That's how they work. They don't like, they want good PR. You didn't have to rob them! And also, you robbed four Subway stores. How much Subway did you eat to offset that?
Well, here's the other thing. Subways are franchises.
Right.
So you're not actually really stealing from Subway corporate.
Nope.
You're stealing from some poor asshole who bought a Subway franchise. I mean, yes, the money eventually trickles up to Subway corporate, but they're not corporate owned. They're franchises.
Well, if it's a Subway and a Walmart, I can't say I feel too guilty.
So you're not really fucking over Subway so much as the poor dude who bought himself a Subway business.
But yeah, that's all... Well, I don't think he was exactly thinking the whole matter through.
Well, I suppose after eating nothing but Subway for a while, you could easily go a little insane.
All right, get ready. This next one, get ready to laugh at my bad pronunciation because I'm not even going to try to pronounce these words because they're in a language that... I view this language as punishment. Not you know, some places they have a bilingual culture, like Canada has French and English alongside each other. Well, in England they have English and Welsh alongside each other in a lot of places, especially in Wales. And they put both on the same they put translations on the same, except you think it's just Japan that can't figure out English? Other places can't understand translations either. Tesco cash machine mistakenly promises free erections.
Oh.
Cash machine outside Tesco Express in... Oh my God, I can't pronounce that. I'd like to buy a vowel.
Aberystwyth.
It's Welsh. It's painful. See? See?
But I can pronounce Gaelic stuff.
The cash machine has been promising customers free erections after a translation error.
I mean, they're not technically lying. Erections are free. Dealing with them isn't always.
Above the ATM at the
But erections are free.
Above the ATM at the news store in West Wales, it translated to colloquially as free erections. It literally, the correct translation literally means lift money without fee, but the adjusted one means erection without fee. And what's killing me is this happened in Wales, which means people who speak Welsh were everywhere.
Yeah. Also, how do you mess up translating something into English when you're the country that invented English? You made English. It's named after you. It's yours.
Can you imagine as they're putting up the ATM, there's like 20 people watching going, are you going to tell them? Nah.
Like I said, they're not lying. Erections are free. I don't know how the ATM could give you one.
I imagine there's some bastard there who the Viagra wasn't working, the Cialis wasn't working. So this was his last hope.
Because, I mean, they don't really vibrate. So,
I smell.
Didn't we do a story forever ago about a guy who tried to fuck an ATM machine? I think we did. Because I recall being mystified about where in an ATM machine there is an appropriately shaped hole to stick your dick.
Probably did.
Because there just is not an appropriately shaped hole for that. I seem to recall being really curious about that. Maybe I was just curious about that. I wonder things.
I can imagine the lawsuit. That sign said I'd get a free erection. Nothing happened. Nothing fucking happened.
False advertising.
Money back, bitches.
I'm not even mildly aroused.
Seriously, that thing's not sexy at all. Didn't even speak sexy.
That would be...
What, a sexy talking ATM?
Yeah.
I don't even want to think about it. I don't want to go there. I don't.
I mean, it kind of has to sing Hey Big Spender, right?
All right. How much of a pain in the ass was college for you?
I mean, I studied art, so not too bad.
Well, I studied English. It was a lot of work for me. And there were also credits that I had to get that, you know, were required.
Yeah, they made me retake 7th grade algebra at 8 in the morning.
I took statistics and probability. I just cruised on by through that one.
You know, when I took my placement exams, they were like, well, based on your verbal scores, you're eligible for our honors program. However, your math scores were almost exactly half your verbal scores. And I'm like, yeah, I'm studying art. Maybe you noticed. I don't math.
This next story made me angry, considering I got my English degree. I didn't do anything related to English with it, but I got my fucking degree, and it was a lot of fucking hard work. So, this story? Fuck you. Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. At Penn, students can get credit for wasting time on the internet.
I should have a doctorate.
Lucky creative writing students at a University of Pennsylvania seminar will be able to earn academic credit for wasting time on the internet next spring. The class, appropriately titled Wasting Time on the Internet, will require its students to spend the 3-hour weekly session dividing their attention between the world of the internet and the classroom. Instructor Kenneth Goldsmith tells the Washington Post that he will strictly enforce a state of distraction among the students. Exactly the sort of thing he and virtually every other professor on Earth spends time trying to eliminate. The purpose, Goldsmith says, is to have students write something good at the end of the course as a result of all that forced distraction. Goldsmith says he hopes the distraction will place his students into a, quote, digital or electronic twilight, similar to a state of consciousness between dreaming and waking, so prized by the surrealist.
If this worked, if that method fucking worked, there'd be a new great American novel once a week.
Fuck yes, I would be goddamn Stephen King.
I would be a New York Times if that worked. That's really dumb method.
I mean, I have to write scripts. And here's how it goes if I'm doing shit on the internet at the same time. Let's see. I've got to get my notes together and I've got to get... Oh, Twitter. Okay. Anyway, I was getting my notes together and let's see. I'm going to do the cartoon bit. Where's my opening mono? Oh, Facebook's got something going on here. Oh, it's a link to ours. Oh, what's going on ours? Okay. Oh, hey, look, there's a thing with the iPhone. Okay. Wait. I've got to... And that's how it goes.
I fall down the BuzzFeed rabbit hole.
Shit, you know, you're like, I'll just check on my email. Then all of a sudden, you're sitting there on Tumblr going, that is the funniest fucking GIF I've ever seen in my life.
Check Twitter, and I follow so many Twitters that link things that I end up, like, spending all day down that rabbit hole with 62 tabs open in Firefox.
Yes!
Like,
fuck these little assholes getting college credit. For fucking... You little shitheads. Goddamn dumbass hippie fucking teacher. Shut the fuck up! The internet is not magic!
And spoiler alert, they're not going to write something amazing at the end of the semester.
No, they're not. They're really not. You'll be
they're going to write you... They're going to write you Harry Potter Avengers / fic.
You'll be lucky if they manage to get an entire complete sentence done.
They're going to write shit like The Wizard of Oz super gay orgy / fic I found once, where the scarecrow gets an erection by all the straw braiding itself and gets fisted by the Tin Man. That's a thing. It's on the internet.
Wait. We just veered off into a dark place.
That's what comes of asking people to use the internet as inspiration for writing, is what I'm saying.
We were talking
These kids are going to find fucking 4chan. And oh, the final exam.
We were talking and suddenly there's a braided scarecrow penis.
Yes. And he got fisted by the Tin Man.
He doesn't have a hole!
They're so mad at me.
Yes, they should be!
It was kind of well written.
All right.
If I only had a hole.
Oh.
Well done.
So,
I mean, it's straw. You can make a hole. You just shove the straw aside. It's not that hard. I'm just going to make sure you got that oil can.
So, it's time for the part of the show where we start to get angry. Bus drivers don't have especially... school bus drivers do not have the best reputation in the world. And a lot of times this is undeserved because they're just doing a job and you're a bunch of crazy little stupid snot-nosed kids who are just giving them shit day in and day out.
You are a grumpy old man, Nash, today.
I am.
It's usually my job.
You're a grumpy old man.
Yeah.
That is some awesome concealer.
You have no idea how much makeup I wear to do this.
Fuck, that is awesome. However, in this case, I am willing to make an exception. Holy shit. This file this under shit that should not happen. New York bus driver caught masturbating while taking student to school.
Oh, no.
An upstate New York bus driver was allegedly masturbating behind the wheel while taking a 14-year-old boy to school. Robert Bertart, 60, of Orangetown, has been fired. Yeah. On charges of public lewdness and endangering the welfare of child. The bus's lone teen was on his way to, a church school early Tuesday morning. Allegedly caught Bertart in the act after glancing at a large mirror aimed right at the driver's lap.
Well, yeah, because they all have those giant-ass mirrors.
How do you do that? How do you carry on a conversation while masturbating?
And driving a bus.
So did you see Big Bang Theory last night? Yeah, it's a good show.
And yes. Driving.
And driving a bus. This is a multitasking shit going on here. Jesus Christ.
Suffer in high school. That's actually not that far from me.
Why would this even remotely seem like a good idea?
You know, he had just come from Tesco. He got the free erection. Had to go to work. What are you going to do? You got to multitask.
When you work a job, you get breaks. You're supposed to get breaks.
In theory.
Remember when labor laws were a thing in America? You get breaks. If you work an 8-hour shift, you're supposed to get at least an hour. It's like a half hour lunch and then 2 15-minute. Yeah, my point is, you have time to yourself. That you could go somewhere private, away from everyone else, deal with Mr. Frisky, and then resume your duties.
I think we all just learned something about you. Mr. Frisky, eh?
What should I have termed it as? The magic weasel?
No.
Trouser snake?
Oh, that's pretty standard.
Purple helmet warrior?
I'm just saying, you went for Mr. Frisky.
I went for Mr. Frisky. I'm trying to be funny here.
And so did he.
Well-known fact. Words with F and K are funnier. That's why fuck is so funny. It's like, linguistically, it's comedic.
Fuck is funny because it's the only word that's every part of speech.
It is. Fuck the fucking fuckers.
Mm-hmm.
It's every word. But my point is here, however, for fuck's sake, I mean, you have your own time. And unless it's with someone who is ahead of time and full consensual age, agreed to it, it's supposed to be private time.
Yeah.
So?
Yeah, unless you've prearranged something else.
Right! It's not share time. You have to set that shit up in advance. It's not just like, you know what? What? Hey, kids, want to see me jerk off?
Hey, don't judge people who jerk off to share. You gotta respect their life choice.
No.
You do. This is how we met, because you're a bigot. You're bigoted against Navikin and apparently share fetishists.
Oh god, I hate you sometimes.
I know.
We're gonna end with some good old-fashioned stupid. Whales are one of those creatures that, well, they live in the ocean the entire lives, and obviously, sometimes they just die in the ocean.
Don't they usually die in ocean?
Sometimes they beach themselves and they die on the beaches, but most of the time...
Yes, but I think most of the time, yeah, they die in the ocean.
Most of the time, it's in the ocean, and it's a, you know, organic matter, it floats. So you got a floating dead whale, this shit happens. It's when you get people involved that we have to make a thing about it. This comes to us from Australia. Australian admits, Mum thinks I'm an idiot. Surfing dead whale was a bad idea. An Australian man who surfed a floating whale carcass surrounded by sharks has admitted he was, quote, an idiot to attempt the foolhardy feat. Harrison Williams, 26, was on a boating excursion with friends off the coast of Western Australia over the weekend when they came across the dead whale. Out on the boat with the boys and one of my mates thought it'd be pretty funny if I surfed the whale. So I just did it. He launched himself across the water and clambered onto the rotting carcass. All right, that's where we start. That's our first problem.
Never clamber onto a rotting carcass.
Never. Of any sort. When the term rotting carcass is invoked, that's a point where you just should take a few steps back, because that's not a good place to be. Have you watched The Walking Dead? Do you know what's shit's nasty. Shit is nasty. But his friend's mirth quickly turned to horror when they noticed all the sharks swimming around the whale feasting on its flesh.
Because, you know, where there's dead stuff, there's stuff eating the dead stuff.
And you know what? I'm telling you, the sharks, they'll eat a dead whale, but you know what they really like? Food that screams.
I don't think that's a rule, actually.
I'm pretty sure sharks are assholes.
I have watched a lot of Shark Week since I moved into a house with a 9-year-old, and I'm here to tell you. Sharks are apparently pretty docile, unless they're really hungry or you're bleeding all over them or, you know, whatever. They're not the clamoring machines of death that sci-fi would have you imagine.
Gershonator went there. He's going to need a bigger dead whale.
No, you need to not surf on dead whales. Leave the dead whales alone.
Just
let them rot and get eaten by sharks in peace.
Who does that? Who sees a corpse? Species be damned. Who sees a corpse and goes, I'm going to get on that?
Yeah, Shani.
What?
We did a story about a guy who fucked a dead squid.
We did.
This is the tamest version of get on that that we have dealt with.
We did.
We should actually be grateful that all he did was surf the whale and not fucking fuck the blowhole.
You know, we were at Brad's party, and I forget how the subject came up, but
I don't like that segue at all.
I have concluded, he was like, I dare you to get on the dead whale. I have concluded that most of the important developments in human history have occurred because somebody says, I dared you to do that. Beer. Hey, see that old barrel full of moldy old hops, full of water? It's just been sort of sitting there for like a week or a couple months. Yeah, I dare you to drink that.
Cow's milk.
Hey, you see a cow? Dare you go suck its titty? Okay. Give me $5. Sure. So, you know, it is not necessarily a bad instinct. It's gotten us to some interesting places.
But yeah, in the Chinese proverb sense of the word.
But, however, sometimes it gets you onto a dead whale surrounded by sharks.
How do you get out of that situation?
Yeah, that's one you go, wait a second.
Because I know from watching Sharknado 2 that Ian Ziering can vault a river teeming with sharks. But I don't think that's something everybody can do.
You lost me when you said, I learned watching Sharknado 2.
You didn't watch Sharknado 2?
No, I did not. And I guarantee you, if I had, I would have learned absolutely nothing.
It's like I don't even know you.
It was better than
Citizen Kane.
I do think the line of the story here is, Mom thinks I'm an idiot.
Yes, so does everybody else, kid. Mom is not alone.
My mom would have beat the shit out of me if I'd done something like this. And I don't care how old I was. If I had been
after boiling you.
if I'd been 10, if I'd been 15, if I'd been 23, my mom would have beaten the shit out of me for this. Yeah, I like that. Jedi says, you're on a dead what?
You know, sometimes you just gotta... As a mother, I'm not a mother, but I imagine if I had a grown son and he called and said, I'm on a dead... As long as the sentence didn't end with hooker, I'd probably be a little relieved.
Wow,
you gotta be a little relieved that you're like, oh, thank God, it was just a whale.
Do you... Wow, look at the faith you have in your genome.
This is why I'm not a fucking mother. There are reasons I'm a professional aunt, okay? You've done this show with me for, what, 5+ years? I shouldn't be reproducing. I think that's clear by now.
Yes. Jesus Christ.
What did we learn today?
Well, the first thing we learned is if it's dead, don't get on top of it!
Ever. For any reason.
Nothing good comes of that.
No.
Do you want to find new and interesting diseases? Then become a doctor. This is not how you do it.
Yeah.
Get a fucking medical degree. Don't go poking corpses.
If you get a medical degree, they'll let you poke holes in people with a stick.
You speak from experience.
With a fucking stick.
With a stick, a wooden stick. That's how they... We've learned that, contrary to popular belief, sharing is not caring. Not always.
Not always.
Sometimes you need to keep it to yourself. We've learned college is fucking worthless.
Officially.
Officially, we've hit the point where it's just...
Which... You know, given the fact that no matter that, like, you spend 4 years getting a degree and you're not going to get a fucking job, you might as well get college credit for fucking around on the internet.
They're not even pretending anymore, is the thing. They're not even pretending that this is, it's like, you know, you're just paying us for the right to work later on in life.
Yeah, but you're not going to get that right. Because you're not going to get a fucking job. So, yeah, learn how to professionally fuck around on the internet, because that's what you're going to be doing. And that's one to grow on, kids.
We've learned that Welsh is hard.
Well, Welsh is hard. But most of the Gaelic languages are a little insane.
But ATM customers not necessarily will be.
Yes. Finally, but it will be free. They didn't lie. I maintain that.
Finally, this week we learned if you really are dissatisfied with the promise of a product, there are avenues to pursue. Armed robbery, not one of them.
I mean, I suppose there are situations where that could be an appropriate response.
Very few, I'd say, and
none. I can't think of any off the top of my head.
Yeah, none would involve Subway.
No.
None would involve Subway. Four Subway! How much Subway did you eat, motherfucker? You know what? If you ate enough Subway that you had to rob four stores to get your money back, I can tell you why the diet didn't work. Just a hunch.